got small arms, long arms, ammunition.
Swaz, right here. This
guy. Yeah, it's true. Shot me ass last year.
Nothing to see here.
Gonna splatter your
my God.
Go ahead and hide, little bleeder! I'll wear your guts around my neck!
Hey, hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Time out. Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn?
I said let him go.
You soft, Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something. Now, why'd you have to go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. You all right, brother?
I'm fine.
Thanks for taking care of him.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Yeah, I feel you.
Good. You stay cool, and you'll be part of the neighborhood. So long as you remember who's in charge.
Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Sure. Let's take a look.
A gun for every occasion.
Whoever this Brotherhood of Steel is, I'm not buying that come in peace malarkey.
Oh, new face walks into my store, and you're not even screaming yet. Very polite. You let me know if anything catches your fancy.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
All the supplies, money, or violence can buy.
Brotherhood of Steel better stay out a good neighbor. All I'm saying.
Vault suit, huh? Hell yeah.
Looks like we got another freak, just won't fit anywhere else.
Your lady friend there, she's the dame who writes public occurrences, right? Good stuff. I always did appreciate good investigative journalism.
Excuse me.
You're blocking my light, man.
Well, well, Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Here for Amari? She's downstairs.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
This one's all yours, Nick.
We need a memory dig, Amari, but it's not gonna be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you two mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait. That's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's an incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right. Let's do this.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of...
Yes.
Flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Is Nick gonna be okay?
Yes, the connections appear to be stable. Hopefully, it'll be as simple as unplugging the implant once we're done. But that doesn't get around the current problem. The memory encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we used to? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
All right, let's get started.
Just sit down over there, and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find. Experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but she loved me in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left. I didn't want to know. Not then. I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though.
What a joke.
What's it mean, Mom?
Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe.
People always hoping for something better. They usually end up with something worse.
Said the NCR would bring back the good old days.
Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
Before the big war.
Don't you listen.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on. The thing about happiness is, you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but, you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like.
Come on, Sarah, you gotta give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
I'm not saying this was a mistake.
I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
I know. But that's where I come in.
Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second.
Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worry.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself.
I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. It was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
There was always a job for someone like me. Didn't matter what it was. Didn't matter who I was supposed to kill. I got pretty good at it.
You pay me? Oh, we'll pay you. And you'll do this all by yourself?
There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. They just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end. One way or another.
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done.
I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
Okay.
That's the way you want to do it? So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really
existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do. I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
B-748. Initiate. System off.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed. And I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Suited me just fine.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. Ah, there's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
The eggheads never like taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me. And I made sure they knew it.
Justin, find him. Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
The eggheads never like taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me, and I made sure they knew it. I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. They didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course. Neither did they. Not really. Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long. I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of, her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but, still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
This is...
I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. I guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have.
The one. Here.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here.
Wait. No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only going to tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
What's the holdup?
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Come on, come on, come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready. Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory, so good news, I think.
Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid, like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up. One of these days, you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter, stronger, and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay. But the cry.
And I can't get over crying.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
It's all over.
Bye.
And nobody's crying.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute, because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there, as soon as you're ready. Okay, I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel? We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute. Virgil, that scientist who escaped.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. This changes everything. He could answer all sorts of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That can't be right. No one would risk going there. Not even to hide.
If we need to find Virgil, then I'm going after him.
If you're going to go, be prepared. You'll need some way to combat the radiation there. It's called the Glowing Sea for a reason.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Rad-X, Rad-Away. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck, and be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. I was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Amari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going. Or I could head back to Diamond City, since you've got company already.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far. Let's see where it takes us next. Commonwealth's not an easy place to travel. Nice to have someone watching my